Hey guys, welcome to the channel. In the previous video, we saw the Celestron Astro Masters series of telescopes. There is another series from Celestron known as Celestron Power Seeker. So in this video, we will compare the top models of both series. The biggest telescope in the Power Seeker series is the Power Seeker 127EQ. This is a Newtonian reflector type of telescope. It has an aperture size about 127 millimeters, which is about 5 inches. It has a focal length of 1,000 meters and a focal ratio of 8. The highest useful magnification of this telescope is 300 times, and the lowest useful magnification is 18 times. This telescope comes with two eyepieces, one is 20 millimeters and the other is 10 millimeters. It also comes with a 3x Barlow lens and a finder scope. The telescope is a little compact, and the length of the optical tube is 508 millimeters. The total weight of the telescope is 21 pounds. This telescope comes with a German equatorial mount. With this telescope, you can see clear images of the moon, planets, and star clusters. The biggest telescope in the Astro Masters series is 130EQ. This is also a Newtonian reflector type telescope. It has an aperture size of about 130 millimeters, which is about 5.1 inches. It has a focal length of 650 millimeters, which is faster than the Power Seeker model. This telescope has a focal ratio of 5. The highest useful magnification of this telescope is 307 times, and the lowest useful magnification is 19 times. This telescope also comes with two eyepieces, a red dot finder scope, but Barlow lens does not come with this telescope. The eyepieces are 20 millimeters and 10 millimeters. Compared to the Power Seeker model, this telescope's optical tube is a little longer. The length of the optical tube is 610 millimeters. The total weight of this telescope is 28 pounds. The telescope has fully coated glass optics, which helps in getting sharper images of the celestial objects. This telescope also comes with an equatorial mount, but the equatorial mount, which comes with this telescope, is different from the equatorial mount of Power Seeker. The 130EQ comes with a CG3 equatorial mount. As this telescope has a shorter focal length, it will give you a larger field of view, which is good for deep space observation. With this telescope, you can see the moon, planets, and star clusters, and some bright deep space objects. This telescope can be considered as an entry level for deep space stargazing. So there are the basic differences between these two identical looking telescopes. Now, which one should you buy? Both of these telescopes are from the entry level series of the Celestron. The Power Seeker telescope is cheaper than the Astro Master telescope. So if you're on a tight budget who wants a decent bigger aperture size telescope with many features, then you should go with Power Seeker 127EQ. The optics on the Astro Master is better than on the Power Seeker. This telescope will give excellent bright images of even faint distant objects. So if you're someone who wants a telescope that is good for observing planets and a little bit of deep space, then you should go with the Astro Master 130EQ. So this is how these two telescopes are different from each other. I hope this video helped you to understand the difference between these two telescopes to make a better buying decision. If it did, then give us a like and subscribe to the channel for more technology related content. See you in the next video. Have a nice day, guys. Peace.